Robin, congratulations.
Thank
first
you
of
so
all, you
much.
Look gorgeous.
Thank you.
And you are the first ever
that is right.
Miss Universe Pakistan ever.
Yes, after 71 years.
That is really amazing.
Like, that is.
You must be so excited to represent your country in a pageant. You're going to go down in history
that is
as
right.
the first. Hmm. How does this make you feel?
It feels amazing. More than excited, as you mentioned, I'm more grateful and humble for this opportunity. And I want to thank Miss Universe for believing in Pakistani women that, you know, we can come out of a comfort zone and compete in a competition and show the world that we are not lesser than anyone.
Yeah, it is not. It hasn't been very popular for Pakistani women mm-hmm. to join Miss Universe pageant. What made you want to go into this field?
So to be honest, there are no pageants in my country. So this is the first time that Miss Universe is given the opportunity to Pakistani women. And if I think about my journey, initially yeah. I started off looking at Shashmita Sen because I'm a huge fan. So I knew that, you know, what kind of criteria it is, what are they looking for. Initially I was very excited, but as soon as I was crowned for Miss Universe, that's the time when I actually, you know, learned the responsibility, what I have, the platform. After when I was crowned, and that gave me a purpose in life to work towards my advocacy that I've been always looking forward to.
Mm. And what was the reaction of your family when you told them that you're going to join the Miss Pakistan Universe, which was held in the Maldives?
Oh, they were so excited. My parents have been my biggest support system in every aspect of my life. Mm-hmm. And I'll share one story. When I was crowned, they were at home watching, and I saw tears in my dad's eyes. Oh. So I think that was very emotional, touched my heart, and they were so proud of me. And that's a message for all the other parents as well. Just support your daughters, just support them, and they can make wonders and make histories.
Yeah. Okay, so before we continue, gusto ko lang sabihin na for the first time, pinapakita ni Erica ang kanyang national costume. Would you
yes.
care to stand up? Just arrived mula sa Pakistan.
Yes.
So can you tell us about this beautiful creation?
Yes. So this is the first time I wore this outfit. I'm so filled with emotions, and I just want to thank Khadi, the one who made this outfit, with so much love. And I have so much to share, so I'll just take it step by step. First, let's go with the color. So black is my beautiful color. This is the color that I chose when I was crowned for Miss Universe Pakistan as well. And I was just sitting and discussing with the team what should be the second color. Although this outfit is representing all the women in Pakistan, but I wanted to, you know, dedicate this to the special woman in my life, that is my mother. So that's why we chose the color pink, because the outfit was designed in October as the awareness of breast cancer, and she's a survivor. She's a survivor, so this pink color is dedicated to her. And if we talk about the design, as you can see, the shells, the sequins, and
all from Pakistan.
Let me tell you, except the fabric, everything is handmade. Each and everything, if you see the thread work, the coins, everything, it actually represents the woman in Pakistan, because art and craft is their life source. Yeah, and I want to send this message to all that, and that's one of my advocacy as well, to promote arts and feel for women in Pakistan, to just come out of the comfort zone, not to just, you know, sit at home and do it, but to go outside and embrace it and celebrate it, and that's the message.
Yeah, you've been in the spotlight because, like you said, everyone was surprised that Pakistan has a representative of the Miss Universe. When you get to El Salvador, what message do you want to say? What do you want the world to know about, not just women, but about your country?
So this is the first time after 71 years that Pakistan is being represented. I want to tell the world that no matter where you come from, no matter what your background is, I don't come from a rich family, but what I do have is a purpose in life. And the purpose is not just for me and myself, it's for others as well. So I believe if your goal in life is to be a better person and to see the change in the world, the whole universe will help you out to achieve it all. Though there were many difficulties that I faced as soon as I was crowned, but I stand here as an empowered woman and so ready to participate and show what Pakistan has to offer.
You look empowered. Let's get back to our seats.
Thank you.
Thank you for allowing me to see your beautiful I think there's also a fan, right?
Oh yes, that's the fan, I'm gonna use that as a prop to estimate the culture and the climate of our region. That is Sindh. So it's used. It's a handmade fan that is used by everyone, not just women but men as well.
Oh really?
Yes.
What about this? Necklace.
Oh, this is also handmade, as I mentioned. Everything is handmade. And this is boho ethnic jewelry, which also promotes the ethnicity and diversity of my country.
Yes. Now, your national director is a Filipino.
That is right.
Josh, a good friend of mine. How has he been to you, and how has he helped you in this journey so far? I understand you've been in the Philippines for 1 month.
Yes. So initially, when I came, I had mixed feelings, you know, a little fear, because again, you know, when you step in a new country, this is my first time in the Philippines. So when you go as a tourist or to work, you know, you just expect the people to, you know, accept you. Mm-hmm. And it's been a month. Now, Philippines feels like home. It's my second home now. I can proudly say it. The love, the warmth, and the hospitality that I receive is immense. I've traveled to other countries as well, but I was amazed because unfortunately I wasn't able to celebrate in my own country because of, you know, winning. So in the Philippines, this was my first ever public appearance, and I was absolutely stunned.
Yeah, and I hear you love Filipino food.
Yes, I love it. I'm a foodie. Also, disclaimer for the people who think that models and beauty girls, queens don't eat. No, we do.
Okay, what are your favorite Filipino foods that you have tried?
Oh, there's so many. Halo halo.
Halo.
Yes.
Do you like ube ice cream?
Oh yes, I love ube. Pandesal.
Pandesal. What's inside a pandesal?
So I've tried two. One is the plain bread, yeah. And the other one I tried with sausage. I think that was the first thing that I tried as soon as I landed in the Philippines. Also, I tried adobo.
Adobo.
Rice. Yeah. Okay. So my national director feeds me so much. We're both foodies, so that's our favorite part of the day.
And of course, you love rice.
Oh yes, I'm a rice lover. Oh, that's also something very common in Pakistan and Philippines, that we can eat rice for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Yeah. So you're coming from a modeling background, which
that is
very
right.
Different from pageantry, the walk, and the whole purpose. I guess you've changed in the last month that you've been here. Tell me about your transformation from model to beauty queen.
Oh, it's a complete 360 angle change. When I stepped in, I was very confident that, I've been practicing modeling for 3 years. Walk is going to be easy, but it's very different. And I really want to thank to all my trainers, especially Ian Lawrence, that he's transformed and, you know, he turned my weaknesses into strength.
Your pasarela.
Yes, and how to embrace it. So I'm really, really thankful to Ian and all my trainers. We went to mental training, walk training, Q&A, so there were a lot of things. But I'm glad. Once I step on the stage on Miss Universe platform, I am so ready, and it's because of my team. So thank you so much.
That's beautiful. And your wardrobe is going to be also Filipino design.
That is right. So my national costume is by one of the celebrated designers from Pakistan, Khadi. And the final gown is from a Filipino designer. I'm not sure if I can reveal the name. It's a secret. But
Filipino designer.
Yes, that is
for
a Filipino.
The and the final.
That is right. That is
wow.
Right.
And did you have a say in the creation of the gown?
Yes, we've named the gown. Can I tell the name? So we've named The One.
The One.
The One. And the reason behind it is I am from the 1% minorities of my country. This is one of the reason, and plus white. So my flag color is green and white. Green is the majority and white is the minority.
In the flag.
Yeah, so we've kept the gown white, silver, and the one, because again, the first ever 1% from the minorities, and also the color. So we've, you know, put everything together, and that's how we created a masterpiece.
Super exciting. And I
Thank
see that you.
You
met Michelle Dee here in the Philippines. How was it? How was your dinner? What did you share about?
Oh, it was so good. So when I initially when I stepped into a pageant world, you know, the first term that came into my mind is it's a competition, right? Yeah. But when I met all the beauty queens, also my co-sisters, Miss Universe Bahrain and Egypt, mm-hmm. it didn't really feel like a competition because, again, this is a platform to empower women.
Yes.
So, and they've been my helping hand. When I met Michelle Dee as well, she was so humble. And we had a really long conversation. We went out for dinner. And that is what taught me a very strong message that you win when you help someone and, you know, when you can be a helping hand.
I like that. You win when you can help someone.
That is right.
That is so true.
That is right.
I love that. You don't have to have the crown, but just a little act of helping someone.
That is true. That is true. And that's the message that I and I'm sure all the 95 countries have to say that we as women are unstoppable.
I like that. Relentless. You mentioned Susmita Sen.
That is right.
As one of the women that you admire. Are there other beauty queens that you... I guess you've watched since you decided you were going to join pageant?
Yes, exactly. So when I joined, I started watching all the videos. Though I've watched the 1994 Susmita Sen's episode 10,000 times.
Oh, 10,000 times.
Yeah, she's not even my favorite, my mom's favorite as well.
Answer, right? Like,
yes, she is. I think she is a woman who just speaks so gracefully. I mean, she doesn't even have to say anything. Her aura speaks louder.
Full of wisdom.
Yes, true. And a purpose. She's done amazing, wonderful work as soon as she was crowned. So that was another message, that it's not just for the year that I have the title. This journey is going to go a lifetime. Yeah. What I've decided is not just going to stay for just Miss Universe Pakistan 2023, the title that I have. It's going to be a long, long way.
So other than
yes,
Sen,
yeah, coming
watch
to that question. I watched a lot of pageant videos, but who I really got inspired with was Catriona Gray, because I met her at the ball. You were there as well.
Yeah.
I met you,
yeah.
And of course she's a star. And as she entered, you know, there were a lot of paparazzis. People wanted to meet her, but Miss Universe Bahrain and I were wearing a sash, and she noticed, and the first thing that as she entered was she came to us she asked that, do you have any questions before going to the competition? I'm here to help you out. You know, I was just shocked and, you know, stunned at that time. I was like, I just want to take a minute because I'm just star-struck at the moment because it's the Catriona Gray in front of me. So again, you know, personalities like these teach you a lesson that to be humble, to be grounded. And to just support each and every woman who you think can make a change.
Yeah. Well, did you ask her anything?
No, I was just I was just standing. But she did give us advices that, you know, always be on time. Again, mm-hmm. be punctual and just be ready because it's a competition. It's going to be tough. So just be mentally prepared. She said before any preparation, you need to be mentally stable and prepared because, again, you know, it's going to be tough.
Erica, it's your first ever pageant.
That is right.
Miss Universe. Yeah,
first and last, I think, because again, it's Miss Universe.
So are you ready?
Yes. Now I can definitely say I am ready, and it's all because of my team, because of Josh Yugen, and they've, you know, when I came up, I wasn't really prepared because again, this is a complete different life journey for me, but with all the trainings and everything, now I can finally say that I am ready.
Beautiful. And you're going to be wearing not a two-piece suit?
No, I am not. Yes, I'll be wearing a burkini because, again, I'm the first one, and I'm the one who will be stepping in to open the doors for other women in my country. I was privileged, and I had a chance to step in, but I'm sure there are many other women that, you know, needs an example. That any woman can participate. You can look beautiful and modest at the same time. And this is the message that I want to tell, that just come out of your comfort zone, and if you have a purpose and you think you are confident enough, you can just embrace, you can just wear anything that you want.
I love your confidence.
Thank you.
And it's your beauty is glowing from within.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So thanks to Josh.
Thank you.
Thank you in your language.
In my language, yes. Can I say the full sentence?
Yes.
Okay. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आप सबका मुझे इतना प्यार और सपोर्ट देने के लिए. बस ऐसे ही अगले साल भी जो भी ब्यूटी क्वीन आएगी उसको भी ऐसी सपोर्ट कीजिएगा कि ये जर्नी आगे ऐसी बरकरार है. शुक्रिया.
Thank you. And we are going to Miss Universe, and this is Miss Universe Pakistan.
Hello, Universe. Thank you.
Oh, nice.